Well, antimicrobial resistance is the phenomenon where bacteria and viruses and other organisms that can infect us develop a resistance to the drugs that we use to treat them.
Antimicrobial resistance is a natural phenomenon and is the ability that bacteria may develop to survive in the presence of antimicrobials, such as antibiotics.
Antimicrobial resistance can occur both in humans or in animals. And it occurs when a microbe is exposed over and over in time to an antimicrobial agent that does not kill it.
While antibiotics have been enormously beneficial since their invention 70 years ago, their improper use has resulted in antimicrobial resistance, which is now one of the biggest global threats.
We estimate that every year across the European Union, there are 25,000 people who die as a direct result of antimicrobial resistance.
It causes many deaths per year in the European Union and in the whole world, and it causes a lot of economical losses due to people getting sick, not being able to go to work. A recent example of a resistant bacteria in connection with food-producing animals is the so-called MRSA, which is Methicillin-Resistant Staphylococcus aureus. This has been traditionally a pathogen for humans. It's one of the hospital-acquired infections. But a few years ago, we started seeing this bacteria also in food-producing animals, and specifically pigs.
All animals carry bacteria in their intestines. These bacteria provide health benefits for the animals. Food-producing animals are often treated with antibiotics. This creates an environment in their gut which favors the survival and multiplication of resistant bacteria. Resistant bacteria can then contaminate food derived from animals, such as meat, milk, eggs, and spread to crops that are irrigated with contaminated water or fertilized with animal manure. Sharing data and collaborating in the way that EFSA, ECDC, and EMA do is integral to reducing the use of antimicrobials in animals and reducing the overall risk of AMR to humans.
It is very important that we tackle the issue of antimicrobial resistance from a global perspective. This is an ecological problem, and it is impossible to find constructive solutions in isolation. That is why it is paramount that the three agencies work together in this problem.
Together, we're collecting data, running surveillance programs to monitor antibiotic use in humans and animals, and publishing reports, which are invaluable to policymakers wishing to lower the risk of AMR.
We've just recently, for the first time, produced a joint report on antibiotic resistance and antibiotic consumption in Europe.
I would say the long-term future is bright, but in the short term, we have to be vigilant on two frontiers. We have to enable the development of new antimicrobial agents, but at the same time, we have to come to grips with the utilization of these agents, otherwise we will only kick the can down the road.
By continuing to work together to tackle this problem, EFSA, ECDC and EMA are reducing the risk of antimicrobial resistance to human health.